Confirman.
No se puede todavía.
Todavía no se puede. ¿Pueden salir y volver a ingresar? Los que me dicen que no pueden, salgan y vuelvan a ingresar porque el cambio lo he hecho recién. Y si ya no se puede, ya comienzo a llamar uno por uno. Está para el lunes 13 de 10 a 12.
De hecho, este
No
cambio
se
no
puede
puedo,
marcar.
¿eh?
¿Tampoco? Por defecto no me permite hacer el cambio. Voy a tener que... Y el otro. No, no me permite hacer el cambio. Ok, entonces pasamos a... Voy a tener que pasar a llamar a cada uno. Abran sus cámaras, porque estamos grabando. Voy a empezar a grabar. Abran cámara los que son de la letra A, B. Para registrar su imagen mientras los voy llamando. Unplay. Let's empiezo con Mariano Abreu.
Presente, profesor.
Wait a second, Mariano, wait a second. Necesito empezar la grabación para irlos llamando poco a poco, ¿eh?
Recording
Okay.
in progress.
So, session that corresponds to Monday, September 13th, Professional English 101N. So please, the students which last name starts with letter A, B, C, start opening your cameras in order to register your attendance. Speak clearly your name, like for example in my case, Juan Acuña, present, okay? In that way. Thank you very much. Start calling. Mariano Abreu.
Presente, profesor.
Okay. Next, Andrea Maya.
Presente, profesor.
Arteaga Vela. Ayala Aguado. Baella Vidal. Campos Villena. Castro Vega.
Your teacher.
Again, please, les estoy pidiendo que digan nombre, apellido y luego presente. For example, Juan Acuña, present, okay? To register that. So, Castro Vega, I repeat.
Efraín Castro, present.
Thank you very much. Next, Chocos Chate. Contreras Salazar.
Eduardo Contreras, present teacher.
Very good. Dextre Camones.
Eric Dextre, present teacher.
Thank you. Díaz Jaramillo.
Cristian Díaz, present.
Ok. Felices Jihuayanca. García Mitma. Garcilaso Romero.
Leonardo García, present teacher.
Leonardo García, present. Garcilaso Romero. González Angulo. Guevara
Ole
Peña.
González, present teacher.
Sorry, repeat again.
Joler González, present.
Thank you. Guevara Peña. Heredia Canales. Hidalgo
Heredia
Martínez.
Canales, present teacher.
Jesús Heredia, present. Hidalgo Márquez.
Andrés Hidalgo, present.
Thank you. Jiménez Olórzano. Yaja Cabezas.
Yaja, present.
Ok, Mar Cuadros. Montes Caja.
Mar Cuadros, present, teacher.
Ok. Montes Caja. Montes Jaramillo. Morales González.
Morales, Miguel Morales, present.
Thank you. Naivares Cayo.
Rodrigo Naivares, present.
Ok, thank you. Jorge Vázquez. Osorio Tixe.
Presente, profesor.
Blas Osorio, present.
Blas Osorio, present. Quien me ha dicho presente, no sé quién es.
Jorge Vázquez.
Jorge Vázquez, present, ok. Paco Taipe y Nostroza. Pinedo, Pinedo. Pomalia Suyo. Quispe Dávalos.
Quispe Dávalos, present.
Sorry again.
Pomalia, present.
Aide Pomalia, okay. And there was a gentleman. Who was a gentleman?
Quispe Dávalos, present.
Okay, thank you. Next, Rodríguez Chuquilín. Rojas Povis.
José Rodríguez, present.
José Rodríguez, present, correct. Rojas Povis. Saavedra Trujillo. Sacaco Maldonado. Segura Castro.
Cristo Segura, present.
Cristo Segura, present. Silva Castro. Solís. Solís Moshko. Vega Ruiz. Ventosía Lázaro. Anybody? Vergara Chauca.
Vega, Farid Vega, Luis Vega, present.
Luis Vega, present.
Anthony Solís, teacher.
Anthony Solís, present.
Miguel Vergara, present, teacher.
Miguel Vergara, present. That's the way, remember? Name, present, okay. Joplak Villanueva, the last one.
John Joplak, present.
John Joplak, present. Okay.
Teacher, Manuel yes. Baella, present.
Manuel Baella. Where are you? Teacher. Manuel Baella, present. Correct. Next.
Teacher. Manuel Garcilaso, present.
No se atropellen, no se atropellen. Deje hablar al primero y luego me da el nombre.
Manuel Garcilaso, present. Manuel Garcilaso, present, teacher.
Manuel Garcilaso, present. Ok. The other person. Héctor Yamamoto.
Teacher.
No lo tengo registrado, Héctor. Y todavía no va. Entonces, Héctor, mándeme un correo electrónico porque es la única forma como yo puedo validar que usted estuvo presente esta sesión.
Profe,
hasta que se regularice.
Profe, disculpe, yo sí. También me matriculé por carta y traté de enviarle porque existía, sí asistí a la primera clase, pero traté de enviarle, le envié un correo, ¿no? Y me respondió sí. Que el correo no existe y así. La dirección
del correo no existe. Mi correo no existe. A ver, voy a mandarles el... Están ahorita... ¿Dónde están sus cámaras? ¿Quién es el que está hablando? Abran cámaras, los que están en este caso, digan su nombre para revisar el video luego y verificar eso con el correo que no se pudo enviar. Acá por el chat les voy a compartir mi correo. Yes, please. Your name, full name, please. And present. ¿No?
My name is Snyder Castro. Present.
Okay. UNI is like this j.acunac.c@uni.edu.be. Envíeme el correo ahora, no esperé a terminar la sesión para que me confirme que fue enviado satisfactoriamente. Está acá en el chat interno. Para ambos casos, para los alumnos que me dicen que se están recién regularizando en lo que es la matrícula, envíenme un correo. Por cada sesión que no los llame, envíenme un correo para que luego... Y en asunto, por favor, póngame asistencia IP101N en proceso. Matrícula en proceso. Eso póngame en asunto para localizarlo rápidamente al momento de hacer el recuento de sus asistencias. Asistencia IP101N, matrícula en proceso. Y como contenido, sus datos, código, nombre completo. Y simplemente presento. Yes.
Yo sí me encuentro en la lista. ¿Puedes marcar asistencia, por favor?
Mr. Montes.
Yeah. Ok.
Ok, Mr. Montes. Mr. Montes, in order to establish your attendance, y esto va a ser de aquí en adelante para todas las sesiones. Cuando los llame, por ejemplo, si digo, if I say, sorry for the Spanish, pero si digo Vega Ruiz, la persona Vega Ruiz me dice Luis Vega present. ¿Ok? Entonces, porque no estoy con la pantalla del Zoom. Entiéndase que estoy trabajando en un móvil donde tengo pantallas de la clase, y la pantalla del Zoom me ocuparía espacio, así que no los estoy viendo. Asumo yo, okay, como ya les pedí, que activaron pantalla, que activaron cámara, dijeron su nombre completo, y cuando yo reviso el video, deben figurar ahí. Así que voy a pedir eso en adelante a todos. ¿Ok? So, repeat, please, los rezagados.
Teacher.
Yes.
Gerson Winchell present.
Okay. Gerson
Winchell.
Wincho. No recuerdo Wincho. ¿Wincho es su apellido o Gerson es su apellido?
Wincho. Gerson es mi nombre, Wincho es mi apellido.
No lo tengo pensado.
Sí, bueno, recién hace poco me habilitaron la matrícula, o sea, ya figuro en Orsen.
Ya, envíeme un correo, Gerson, porque no tengo actualizado acá el...
Yeah,
Profesor, disculpe, ahorita le pedí enviar de vuelta el correo y me sale que usuario no ha encontrado.
¿Otra vez? Strange. A ver.
Pineda, profesor.
Un momento, Pineda. Jay está poniendo a cuna con N y no con Ñ, ¿no?
Sí, como envió al chat, ¿no? Ese mismo correo.
A ver, envíeme su correo en un mensaje privado. Voy a escribirle un mensaje. Qué raro que no me encuentre. Tengo abierto el correo, está bien. Ok, ahora me que no existo.
Profesor, creo que está una C de más en su correo.
Tengo el correo activo, a ver si lo voy a copiar del mismo correo. Ah, ok. Tiene razón. Pude haber cometido, no estoy revisando ahorita el chat, pero pude haber cometido ese error que le he puesto una C de más. Ok, déjenme ver. Mil disculpas si es que ha sido así, ¿eh? Paso al chat. A ver cómo lo puse. Ah, tiene usted razón. He cometido el error de una C más en la CUNAC. Perdón, pero... A ver, les escribe entonces el correo de acá de ACUNA. .c, acuna.c, disculpen, at uni.edu.edu. Yes, es j.acuna.c. Curioso que haya cometido el mismo error la otra vez. Ok, ahora sí, envíenme el correo, por favor. Pineo, ya, paso con su asistencia, a ver, por favor. Pineo. Pinedo.
Edwin Santiago.
Pinedo y Santiago. ¿Alguien más que haya llegado rezagado?
Víctor Montes Jaramillo.
Víctor Montes Jaramillo, ok, correcto. Y el último.
Jair Montecillo. Ventosilla.
Sí. Ok, no se amarguen, solamente que necesito que hablen claro. Ok,
Jeremy Flores present.
Jeremy Flores. Jeremy Flores. ¿Está en la sección N, Flores?
Sí, sí, profesor.
Ya, no lo encuentro en mi listado, envíenme un correo. Igualito, recuerden, asistencia IP101N. Y también pónganme matrícula en proceso porque no lo tengo en mi listado original. Para estos alumnos que no figuran y que ya recibieron una comunicación confirmando su matrícula, envíenme una foto o una captura de pantalla de un comunicado que precise que ya están dentro del grupo, ¿ya? Para poder tener un sustento por si tengo problemas en adelante de que no se reconoce que están ustedes en el grupo. Yes, anybody?
Teacher. Luis Paco present.
Y ya, con los rezagados también voy a tener una política de que después de los 10 o 15 minutos ya no voy a recibir más rezagados. Paco Taipe, porque imagínense, voy a dedicarle 30 minutos a asistencia solamente. Paco Taipe, and the other is.
Mauricio Campos, present.
Víctor Ayala, present, teacher.
Ok, ahora, al final, si llegan más rezagados, lo siento, pero al final siempre tomo una fotografía o capturas de pantalla de los presentes. Ahí ya entro yo a ver quién estuvo y quién no estuvo. Ya, ok, ya usted sale en la foto, lo siento. Ya tengo que empezar clase. Tranquilos que igual yo hago la comparación. Igual en el chat me pueden poner ustedes sus nombres y por lo menos tener una participación con cámara para efectivamente comprobar que estuvieron acá los que llegaron tarde y no los pude llamar y ver qué está pasando con esa asistencia. Let's see. If you access to campus, I uploaded some material that we are going to use for the tenses, for past tenses. Let me see. Okay, let's see. Week number 2. Past tenses and present perfect tense is what we have here. I'm sharing the screen. Sharing sound too. Hiding floating. Permit me the class. Okay. So, tense reviews. The last session, we revised present tenses. No? Present simple, used for facts, routines, and habits. Present continuous or progressive, to use to express activities or actions that are happening right now. So, in this tense review, simple past, past continuous, and present perfect tense is going to be used. Or it's going to be revised in this class. The simple past is established in order to present cases or situations of some actions that finished in time and they happened at a specific moment in the past. For instance, we have this. She wasn't working, is the past continuous. tense. In this case, the past continuous is used in order to establish an action that was in progress in the past. So, for example, I was working, for example, the context is like this. I can say I was working, sorry, was working when you called. The past continuous establishes here what was the situation or the context. The situation was that I was working. Was working give me the reference of an action or an activity that occurred during a time, let's say 8 hours, no? And in that moment, for example, I was interrupted by your call, because you called. So we establish the situation like this. In time, talking about past, let's say that during this moment, during this period of time, I was working. I started 8 o'clock in the morning until 5 o'clock, until 5 o'clock in the afternoon. So I can say 5 or 6, if you want. I started at 8. And somehow during that time that I was working, so it's established by this, during this time that I was working, you called. So I received your call, but your call was maximum, let's say 5 or 10 minutes. And then I continue working. Or you called, and then I stopped working. But I was working establishes an activity that was happening when the interruption arrived. Now, the past continuous tense is precisely was or were with the verb in past participle. That is the past continuous. So was or were plus the verb with ing. That is past continuous. The simple past is the interruption here. I use the simple past in order to give you the idea of what was happening. No? It was a situation occurring. We were listening to the class when the earthquake happened. So it's again an interruption. That is the idea of this past. Simple past is the interruption in this case. The simple past is interruption. And the past continuous is what is happening right there. That title should have been, instead of simple past, past tenses. So to be checked. So the past continuous is this. Okay. Now, ways to form this, or the different forms to check the word formation, just remember the use of the verb to be in past tense, where we have for I, we, or he, she, or it, was, for we, you, and they, were. And as you know, the verb has to be with ing. Remember, you have to remember certain points. For example, you have to remember that when using any verb like work, ing, but there can be verbs like, for example, run, where you have consonant, vowel, consonant, and you have to double the last consonant. So running with double N. Running with double N. Or, for example, you have study. For the study, don't eliminate anything. You just put ing, and you have studying. Then we have other verbs that end in letter E. For example, write. In that case, cancel the letter E and write ing. Writing. Those are the spelling rules that we have to pay attention when working with ings. In present progressive, in past progressive or continuous, in present perfect continuous, all the continuous forms, and also gerunds. So that is what we have. How do we form questions in past continuous? This is, I'm going to change this, not to confuse you. You see? Instead of simple past, a better a better statement here is past tenses. So here this topic or this slide corresponds more to past continuous or progressive more than simple past. So past continuous. Okay, better. Yes, because here we have the structure that corresponds to past progressive or past continuous. Sorry for the noise outside. Now, the negative form is written with not, but when we have was not or were not, we can also have the contractions, as we have here, wasn't, or in the case of were not, the contraction is weren't. Wait a second. Okay. Wearing and lowercase letters. Much better. So we can use were not or weren't working. In order to make questions, we just change the order. The verb to be first, and then the verb with ing. So was I working? Was she working? Were you working? And for short answers, in this case, you can say yes, he, she, or it was, or no, he, she, or it, I wasn't. Yes, you, we, or they were, or no, you, we, or they weren't, as we have in the slide. So, save this. Next, let's continue. Erase clear drawings, and let's continue. Now, the use of, again, this, there is a mistake here in this slide. Let me correct this, please. We are going to put, instead of simple past use, we are going to put past continuous use. So we have to talk about the past action at some point, as I told you before, is an action in progress in the past that you established, and then we had an interruption. Like, for example, they were having dinner when we arrived. What is, we were having dinner 1 hour, and during that hour, just 1 minute, or in some moment during that hour, we arrived to have dinner with you or just to visit you. The difference is, as they say here, they were having dinner when we arrived, is they started dinner before we arrived, and they had dinner when we arrived. When we use past tense or simple past in both cases, is they had dinner, they finished dinner, and then we arrived. No? So it's one event after the other. But if you say we were having dinner when we arrived, is in the middle of the dinner, we arrived. Okay? Now, let's move. Clear drawings. Let's move. Something that we have to pay attention, and here you're going to participate a little bit more, is when we talked about simple past tense, because these regular and regular irregular verbs are, or is more notorious when we talk about simple past. I'm going to put between parentheses here. We are talking about simple past cases. Simple past tense. Change color. Okay. We have to respect certain word formation rules or conditions. In some cases, for regular verbs, we are going to just add ed. For example, bake, baked. For example, paint, painted. No? just Didi. In other cases, similar to, as we repeated the last consonant for running, R-U-N-N-I-N-G, we are going to do the same with the ED or the regular past tense form. But notice that we have something in common for this rule. We have one syllable, and if you pay attention, we have this combination. Consonant, vowel, and consonant. When we have these combinations in a word that is one syllable, and we have to add some suffix, like ed, ing, er, est, for adjectives that we are going to check afterwards, we have to repeat the last consonant. So we have stopped with double P. Please, the pronunciation is not a stop it, but it's a stopped. That is something that we have to pay attention also, how to pronounce them. For example, it's not bake it, but it's baked, stopped, fried, state. As a parenthesis, I'm going to tell you something. As a parenthesis, okay. And pronunciation. In the pronunciation part, we have to consider that to the ED termination or ending, we are going to adopt the pronunciation of D or in some cases of other combinations T. Something very, very hard. In very, very specific cases, for example, when we have the combination of TEDs or DEDs, only in those circumstances, we are going to pronounce like TIT or DIT. For example, TED, like DIT, we can just play past tense, play it. In the case of T, we have one example here, stop. Past tense, stopped. How is the pronunciation similar here? Please do not criticize this part because I'm going to give you an approximation of the pronunciation. It's not a formal pronunciation phonetic frame, okay? We are going to pronounce this like played, approximately. It's not a phonetic equivalent to the word pronunciation, just in case. And for stop, it's going to be like this, stopped. That's the pronunciation that we are going to adopt with past tense. But when we have the combination TED, for example, paint, in that case, we are going to pronounce like this, painted. That is going to be our pronunciation, painted. And for EDs, for example, persuade, past tense persuaded, it's going to be like this, persuaded. Yes? So, from now on, if you have the pronunciation of these words, try to consider that the only two situations or conditions that we are going to use, you know, need extra space. The only two conditions that we are going to pronounce the last part of the regular verb in past tense is only when we have the combination of TEDs and DEDs. The other cases are D or T. Which is with which? Normally with T that is strong, we have strong consonants. For example, letter K, letter P, SH, CH, G, changed, for example. No, there are some combinations that we have to check that. What are you going to do? First, take a look at the rest of the cases. For example, when we have a consonant Y, that's the case of fry. For example, here, fry, The past tense is write. What did they do? They cancel, they omitted the letter Y, they cancel Y, and they add IED. It's a case of a study, for example, also. No? Study, past tense, studied. All right. And when we have a vowel Y, it's like a normal verb. No? For example, pay, play. You, what is the past tense? Play. That is a Y after a vowel. Oh, for example, state. That is the case here. So what are you going to do? You are going to put these verbs here, the following verbs that we have here, into each group, into the group of ED, double consonant, consonant Y, where we eliminate Y and add IED, vowel Y, where we have to just add ED. So in what groups they are? Let's go with fry. Fry is the, here we have the example. So bake is done, fry is done, stay is done, and stop is done. Let's continue with complete. What is the past tense for complete? Can you help me? Yes. In which of the groups can we put them? I'm going to put here some reference letters for the cases. Let's say, for instance, we have here case letter A, case letter B, case letter C, and case letter D. So complete just end in letter E, so we have to add just the D then. So we can put here completed, right? Next, other similar case. If we take a look at all the verbs, I have hire. Hire, that means contract. Past tense, contracted or hired. Then I'm going to mute here to continue.
Also promised.
Sorry, I had some noise, environmental noise. That is why I closed my microphone. But yes, promised. Remember, it's promised, not promised. Promised. That is the pronunciation. Thank you very much. Now, with a stop. With a stop, we have to pay attention to the combinations I told you. Not normally, one syllable can be also two syllables, but the last syllable is stressed. But here we have one syllable. We have to repeat the last consonant and then ED. Remember the combination, consonant, vowel, consonant, can referring from backwards. So that is stopped, then what? Any other? Complete? No. Try? No. Wrap. Wrap. Double B, ED. Wrapped. Other? Can you help me here? Is there any other, or is the last one?
Refer.
Very good. Yes, but refer is has two syllables, right? Has two syllables, but the second syllable is stressed. I mean, the pronunciation is refer, not refer. If you say refer, then it's only ed. But because the pronunciation is refer, referir, then the stress goes in the last syllable, F-E-R, we have the combination. Consequently, we repeat the last consonant and then ED, referred. Yes. And that's it. Just in case, a note here, triple asterisk. It doesn't exist double X, doesn't exist double W, and doesn't exist double Y. Okay. For example, fixed. Past tense, the past tense for fixed is fixed. Like this, with double X. Is that okay?
No,
because we don't have double X, double Y, or double W. Okay, so the correct expression here is fixed, just with one X. So here we have to put double consonant plus ED, yes, but be careful. Red color here, be careful. It doesn't exist. Exceptions, except X, W, and Y. Double consonant plus ED, except X, W, and Y. So in this case, of the letter X is only one ED. Next, let's continue. With the consonant Y, so we have fry, other case.
Right.
Try, very good, tried. Other case, is there any other?
Cried.
Cried. Yes, cried, past tense. Any other?
Tidy
is to put in order. So tidy. And no more.
Prayed.
Again? Cry is there. Pray is vowel, no? Vowel Y.
Okay.
Yes. Vowel Y are the rest. For example, state, the rest of them. What is it? You said prayed. D only, O-E-D. The other is play. But play is in the previous example. Played. Is there any other? Destroy
it.
Yes, sir. Destroy. Those are the examples. Very good. So there we are. Si tienen ustedes un grupo WhatsApp, son libres de tomar sus capturas de pantalla y compartirlas al grupo. Generalmente, cuando manejamos la clase así, estamos colaborando con los que no pudieron, y con ustedes mismos que luego quieren revisar lo que se hizo en clase y está ahí a la mano. So, clearing here, eso sí tiene que ser rápido porque generalmente termino la lámina y paso a lo siguiente. So, clear drawings and let's go. Now, the present perfect tense. Somehow, we have revised simple past, past continuous, and now present perfect. What is the difference? The present perfect tense is going to give us the idea of an action that started in the past. Let's say started in the past. This. This action started in the past and probably may continue in the future. Probably. Or also it's possible that the action just finished. Continue in the future, or it's a possibility that just finished. For example, we can say text. No format means format that. For example, we can say something like, I have studied Engineering. Engineering for how many years or how many months? How long have you studied engineering so far? For example, my subject corresponds, or this subject corresponds to the sixth semester or the fifth semester or the fourth, four, five, or six. Don't remember very well. Now they have changed the curriculum. So what is the semester that that you studied English or professional English? Eighth semester. Okay, thank you very much, Mr. Baella. So four years, approx. No, if we calculate correctly for four years, no, it's too much. We can say that you studied English in order to finish the basic level. Engineering is okay. I'm talking about engineering, not English. For 4 years. Sorry, it was a lapsus. So I have studied engineering for 4 years, calculating 8 semesters, 4 years. So you are not specifying when you started the study. You just say the quantity of time. Is it going to continue? Yes. 1 year more and I finish the career theoretically. Next, with present perfect tense, you don't give an exact time. For example, you can say we have studied with who is a professor that you studied in for physics? Let's say physics, a professor of physics. Because I assume that if you are in eighth semester, you are not studying physics anymore, are you? Physics is física. ¿Están estudiando algún curso de física ahora? Pueden responder, ¿eh? Porque el chat, tengo que recurrir al chat. No, come on, Maella. 8 years impossible. Si son ya 8 años, ahí hay que replantearse las cosas. Ok, so, a good professor of physics, please, para que me ayuden a avanzar con el ejemplo. Entiendo que quieren darle cierto color al curso. We have studied with, please give me names.
Yamoha.
Okay, how do you spell Yamoha? Double L or Y?
Double L.
Double L, okay. So we have studied with Professor Yamoha. Professor Yamoha. Okay. Notice that you are saying we have studied with Professor Yamoha. Necessarily, are you necessarily studying with Mr. Yamoha now? No. Did you study with Mr. Yamoha in the past? Is my experience. Yes. When exactly? No, I don't give you that information. Why not? Because I'm talking about present perfect tense. In present perfect tense, the time that you did the activity is unknown. Unknown es desconocido. No se conoce cuándo hicieron, pero sí tiene la experiencia de haber estudiado con el profesor Yamoha. So, it's very different, and I'm going to put with different color, it's very different from simple past. In simple past, you would say, I studied physics with Professor Yamoha in, and you give me a year, no? Calculating 2021, 3 years ago could be 2018, for example. Is very different because you are giving the exact information of the time. So then this is not present perfect. This is simple past. The same situation, more information about time demands simple past, no present perfect. If you put the time, automatically you have to change your tense. Okay. Now, The form, we have two auxiliaries. Have, in the case of I, you, we, they, has, for the case of he, she, or it. The apostrophe VE and the apostrophe S correspondingly correspond to their contractions. The verb that we have here, that we are going to use with it, is not simple past, because for regular verbs, looks like simple past. But in this case, we are going to use something or some form that is called past participle. Past participle. So that is very important. How do I notice the difference between simple past and past participle? Well, for example, in regular verbs, it's not very clear unless you pay attention to the auxiliary. But for example, we have verbs like taken. We have verbs like, for example, read. No? Then you can notice easier the difference among them. So we can say, I have finished. You have taken. They have read. Yes. For the case of negatives, have not or has not, we have the contractions, has not, correspondingly. We have the contraction haven't or hasn't. And again, the verb is in past participle. So the verb, past participle. For the case of questions, we have to reverse the order. First, the auxiliary verb, have or has, here. And then the subject, are you, we, they, for have, is she, or it, for has, and the verb in past participle all the time is like this, verb past participle. For short answers, you can say yes or no, are you, we, they, have or haven't, he, she, or it, has or hasn't. Remember this, this is a very important thing. When using have or has, you have to use the verb in past participle all the time. In regular verbs, the past participle and the simple past are both formed with ed. That is something that may create confusion. What is this, simple past or present perfect? So the context is going to give you the idea. For example, if I say we've studied with Professor Yamoha, and suppose that they are using the contraction with that you cannot notice very well, but they didn't mention the time, definitely it's present perfect. If they say, I studied physics with Professor Yamoha in 2018, because they mentioned the time, definitely is simple past. If you cannot get the auxiliary, notice that what we just studied, in past simple and past participle for the regular verbs are the same. There isn't any difference. Arrive, arrive, play, played, visited, visited, stopped, stopped, the same. So that is what is present perfect tense. What is the difference about or from present perfect and simple past? The time information, just that. So, passing to the next slide. Clear drawings here. Ready? Okay, next. So the use is like this, as explained before. To talk about past, but not time reference, to show, for example, experience, we can say Elena has arrived or Elena arrived. We are talking about the result that we can see right now for some action that happened in the past. So the uses of present perfect correspond to experience. Then the use of for and since, for example, where since establishes exactly the point of time that you started the activity. I have been here since January, or I have studied engineering since 4 years, you said, no? 2017. Or I have studied engineering for 4 years. You can say that. Now, are these the other, well, this is present perfect versus simple past. There are other expressions that we use with present perfect tense, apart from for and since. So we have the use of already, changing color. We have the use of already. We have the use of just. We have the use of ever. We have the use of yet. we have the use of still. And the question, how long? I think I'm missing something. Already for just, since for just, ever, yet, still, yes, that is. What does already mean? Already means anticipated to the time. In Spanish is like ya, but anticipated to the time. For example, suppose that what week do we have the first evaluation according to the calendar? ¿Ya recibieron su calendario de la programación de pruebas o de prácticas?
No, teacher.
No. Pero imagínense que un profesor decidió ya tomar su primera práctica. Imagínense, ¿no? Semana 3 y ya tomó la primera práctica. Creo que es la semana 4. Semana 3 y ya tomó la primera, ya la tomó, ya la evaluó, ya la corrigió todo. Ese profesor se adelantó, o profesora se adelantó al calendario, pero ya lo hizo. Ese es un already. So we can say he has already evaluated. He has already assessed. It's much better. Assessed his group. Okay. But this week is week number 2. Yes, but he did. Okay. So then, in that case, we assume the use of already. Already means in Spanish ya, pero anticipándose a la fecha oficial. Ya ha sido evaluado. Pero eso debió ser la próxima semana. Ya lo hizo. He has already assessed. What is the position of this? Is between the auxiliary has or have, depending on what you're using, and the verb in past participle. So that is the position of already, which is the same position of just. But in the case of just, the concept is different. Just has to be with acaba de, or just happened. No? For example, Jesús Arteaga, Jesús has just answered the question. Acaba de, right? And it's the same position, no? Just goes between have or has and the verb in past participle. Ever. Ever is more connected to negative or to questions. For example, the question is, have you ever cheated on a test? ¿Alguna vez han hecho trampa en un examen? And don't answer, please, don't answer. And the other is, for example, for negative, I have not ever been to Russia. I have not ever been to Russia. That is for negative. In the case of a question, it means alguna vez, have you ever, alguna vez. And in the case of negative, have not ever means nunca has estado en Rusia. So that is the ever use. Remember that the concept that we have for questions is alguna vez has, no? O alguna vez ha. The other case is nunca he, okay, for negative. Now, yet. Here. Yet has, yes, Mr. Ryan.
Podría ser también, I have never been to Russia.
Certainly, yes. And never is also used, but with some, I'm going to put never here. Never is used in present perfect, but with certain restrictions. So for example, the case that you mentioned is very, it's a good example. I have never been to Russia. And I'm going to tell you why, Manuel, to Russia. I'm going to tell you why. Because the situation is very logical. When you analyze this in English, you say, So it was logical after all, yes. If you say not ever, the equivalent expression that you obtain is... When you just connect not and ever, what you obtain is never. Huh, interesting. Yes, that is as simple as that. So English can be very simple if we keep the logic. So yes, that is. Thank you very much. Now, yet, I'm going to keep this until I get to how long, okay? What happens with yet? With yet, it happens that we have two situations. I can use yet for questions, or I can use yet for negations. The most common way to present yet is in negations. For example, we have not, or haven't, is the same, please. We have not had our first test yet. And yet, in that case, for negative means aún todavía. But if I make a question, I can say, have you finished that project yet? So when we have a negation, in the negation, yet means aún todavía. But when we have yet in a question, it means ya han terminado ese proyecto, right? So it's different from the ones that we have considered in the negation part. Still is the same as yet for negative, only for negative. For example, but the location is different. We use yet at the end of the statement, still is used before. For example, we have not had our first test yet. I can put this like, we are still, la misma oración, but using still. We still haven't or have not had our first test, that's it. We still have not had our first test. The same as we have not had our first test yet. What's the difference? Because it's somehow, the meaning is the same, but somehow it gives some differences. If you use yet, you mark more emphasis. We have not had our first test yet, more emphasis. We still have not had our first yet. Is the principal idea is no test. With the case of yet is yet. So it's time that we have to prepare for our test because it's time to get it. Now, how long? How long is cuánto tiempo? How long? Remember my question. How long have you studied engineering? How long have you studied engineering? So you can say, well, I have studied engineering for 4 years. I have studied engineering for 6 years. I had to stop studying for some reasons. And everybody has a different story, different experience studying engineering. So those are the cases. Those are the rest of the words. So we can use since, desde, we can use for, durante. We can use already, ya. We can use just, acaba de. We can use ever, that is alguna vez o nunca. We can use yet, aún o ya. We can use still, aún. We can use how long, cuánto tiempo. Or we can use even never, that you discover is the same as not ever. I have never been to Russia, for example. Now, those are the expressions that we are going to use with present perfect tense. In simple past and past continuous, we have also a group of expressions. Then I'm going to return back to the to the simple past tense. Ready there? Yes? Shall I continue? ¿Me confirman? ¿Continúo?
Yeah, teacher.
Si yes? Okay, thank you very much. Recuerden la sugerencia, compartan si pueden las capturas de pantalla en el grupo WhatsApp que tengan para hacer más ágil su grupo también. The simple past use, I'm going to put here, what are the expressions that we use in simple past that are connected to simple past? So I'm going to put useful expressions or typical expressions. That is other form that they call this. First, the typical one, yesterday, no? We have yesterday, definitely simple past. Last, when you say, for example, last month, last week, last class, month, week, year, etc. When we have a goal, for example, 2 weeks ago, or 3 months ago, or 1 year ago, 1 decade ago, whatever you want, but ago. No? Or if we have a specific times, no? For example, 2001, in 2001. For example, the attack to the Twin Towers in the World Trade Center was in 2001, for example. So when we have a specific times, we have to use the simple past tense. Okay. Now, so clearing here, and let's continue. Let's continue to when to use one or the other. When to use the simple past tense or the present perfect, because it's a constant debate or analysis that we have to make. When they say, I've worked for the bank for 3 years, the intention is that probably the person is still working for the bank. That is why he said, I started in the past 3 years ago, but now I continue. That is why I can say, I've worked for the bank. In past tenses, I worked for the bank for 3 years. Now the person doesn't work for the bank. Now the past continuous or past progressive is what we have already revised. The past continuous or past progressive is what we have here. It's a repetition of the last part. So we finish with this. And let's continue with some exercises, okay? Because this is theory and also practice. So then, we are going to check something about the practice of this. Let me share with you some exercises. Connected to distances. I want to finish the class of today with passive voice so that we can, the next session, we can enter to professional English. Let me see, intensive. Books and material. Books and material. Let's check simple past. I'm going to attack this . Let's see if I can use Campus now. Campus. Not helping, close. Not helping, close. Campus helping, yes. And where is Campus? No Campus here? No. Virtual, no, horario. Professional English. And editing all. No, editing all. Week number two. Add an activity. And we have a label. If you access to campus, please, week number two, I propose you an exercise where it says, put the verbs in brackets into the correct form of the past symbol, only the past symbol. Access to that exercise, solve the exercise, because then we are going to, I'm going to ask you to participate more actively by giving the answers of this, please, okay? So start doing that. Remember that our classes must be theory, but also practice. And participation is considered, is always considered. So it's convenient for you and for everybody. That is simple past only. Two exercises for simple past, two for sure. Past continuous. Yes, sir.
We write in the chat. We have write in the chat.
No, write it. This is just for you. It's for you. It's not homework. Write, for example, you can use that image in your computer, and if I ask you the answers, give me the answers. Or if I ask you, please, can you share your answers? You can share that. No. It's just for you. It's not a task. So solve that, and then I'm going to call for the answers. No? It's like that. I'm trying to simulate if we were studying in a classroom, for example, is your book, solve the exercises, and then I call for the answers. Just that. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Everybody, please access to campus. For the people who have not access to campus, por ejemplo, los que están en proceso de matrícula, no creo que haya limitación en que integren el grupo WhatsApp de grupo. Así que no tengo ningún problema en que compartan este ejercicio en el grupo WhatsApp para que todos dispongan de él, inclusive los que están en proceso de matrícula. Okay, adding exercise to campus. Okay, so two exercises for simple past. One exercise for simple past and present continuous, and one for simple past versus present perfect. Thank you. If we don't finish all these exercises, I'm going to ask you to do it. Week number two. That is simple past versus past continuous. And the last one, simple past versus present perfect. Hope to have enough time to finish it. Si no llegamos a continuar, ya los ejercicios me los pueden enviar por correo in order to check your participation and also your effort after the class. And the last one.
Teacher.
Yes.
Solo ha dejado un ejercicio de past simple, ¿verdad?
No, there are three. There are three so far. Refresh, please. Refresh.
Ah, okay.
I have found some a list of expressions that we use with present perfect, more complete than the ones that we used. But right now, I'm going to share this with you afterwards. Present perfect versus simple past. Okay, because you and I has to be a challenging exercise. This looks pretty challenging. Okay, so this looks pretty challenging. I was planning to close, well, it can be the next class. The next class. With these bases, we can start the professional English easily. And the last one. Okay, there are four exercises. We are going to work now. Now that you are aware about what we are doing, we have those exercises. I'm going to add a label here to classify them. Labels. Exercises that corresponds to simple past. Simple past tense. Six. Bold. Okay. And the color. simple past tense, and zero return. Any simple past tense is here. Two minutes and we start checking, okay? But I need you to start doing those exercises in order to correct your work.
Teacher.
Yes, sir.
Only two exercises of simple past or
no? Can you refresh your, because there are four. Two for simple past, one for past continuous versus simple past, and one for present perfect versus simple past. Those are. There are four tasks.
Teacher, for now?
Yes, right now we have 29 minutes to do it.
Can you repeat, teacher?
Yes, there are four exercises or tasks that I have just shared with you. I need you to start doing them in order to start doing together as a whole class to confirm the answers. So access to those images, start solving them, because at 11:35, I'm going to start working with you and I need you to give me the answers that you obtained for them. Obviously, participation is considered. It's not an evaluation. It's not an exercise. Imagine that I put a mathematical operation here on the board. I'm asking you to try solving that or solve it. And then after 5 minutes, we are going to check how to solve them together. That's the intention. Yes, sir. Just there. Los ejercicios son para ustedes, no son ejercicios para entregar. Lo que necesito es que lo vayan resolviendo para luego hacerlo juntos. Y ustedes ya me den respuestas y no estar recién preguntando qué pondrías tú aquí, qué pondrías acá. Eso empezamos en 3 minutos, ¿ok? 11:35. No es mucho tiempo, así que vayan viendo sus respuestas a los ejercicios. I suppose that is the time that I will have in order to obtain here. This title is better, I think. Yes, too much. 1 minute to check. And present perfect. Okay. Okay. So let's access. Open image in a new tab, and we go here. I think you can observe from there. Zoom sharing. Okay, let's start sharing this. Let's start sharing this. Now let's go with the answers, okay? Sorry, ma'am, but I dropped the glass on the floor. Never mind. This is put the correct form of the past simple only, no? So never mind, just be careful next time. Case two. You watched the horror film last night. Notice that they have last night, simple past. What is the auxiliary that we use in simple past? Anybody?
Did.
Very good. Did. So the question here is did. After the subject, you, and after the subject, the verb. So we have, exactly. Very good, Mr. Pinedo. Did you watch the horror film last night? Yes, but I, and you have to express something in negative with the verb enjoy, negative.
Yeah. Didn't enjoy.
Very good. So yes, but I did not enjoy. I'm going to put it completely because you understand I am teaching everybody, did not enjoy. So it's for people in basic, etc. Did not enjoy. Sir, can I use didn't? Yeah, definitely. When we use did, remember that the form of the verb is base form. We don't use any verb in past tense because the auxiliary verb give the past tense. Okay. Now, letter A. In a similar case, your neighbors moved house yesterday. So, did your neighbors, vecinos, move? Did your neighbors move? Ah, sorry, British English. British English is OU. Moves. Okay. Did your neighbors move house yesterday? Yes. We, and this is affirmative, we have to use the verb help in simple past tense. So yes, we help. Remember, not help it, help. Number four, any volunteer? Now I ask for volunteers.
A train crashed last night.
Yes.
The answer is, I know, luckily all the passengers survived.
Luckily all the passengers survived. Yes, survived. Correct. Thank you very much, Mr. Garcia. Now next, number five, any volunteer?
Susan did not play tennis yesterday.
Okay. Yes, Mr. Pinedo, I know.
I know she's playing today instead.
Yes, sir. Yes. Very good. Thank you very much. Now next. Number six. Anybody?
Yeah, teacher.
Mr. Bahia?
Did you see Kate yesterday?
Did you see Kate yesterday? Yes. The answer?
Yes. Yes, we had lunch together.
Yes, we had lunch together. Okay. That was just a warm-up. No? So, fue un calentamiento. So, take a screenshot, share with the group via WhatsApp. Let's go to the rest because of the time, clear drawings. And let's go to the next. Let's go to the next exercise. Open image in a new tab. Can you see that exercise? Can you confirm me, please? Can you see that exercise? Yes, okay.
Yes, teacher.
Increase the size. Not too much. Okay, there. It's a story of Ferdinand Magellan. So it says, Ferdinand Magellan was a Portuguese sailor who what? Anybody can participate, huh?
Who wanted
to sail around the world. Emperor Charles V of Spain
Gave.
Gave him. Very good. Gave him 5 ships and 265 Spanish sailors. They
left.
Now notice that we are using irregular verbs too. They left Spain on the 20th of September, or September 20th, 1519,
and began,
no problem with that, and began their long and dangerous journey. On the journey, Magellan
discovered.
Very good. Discovered, yes, the Pacific Ocean. Unfortunately, he and many of his sailors, or the sailors,
died
in a battle on April 27th, 1521. After that, a Spanish sailor took control of the ships and what?
Set off.
The past tense for set is set. So it's set off. Very good. And set off. Who's participating? Mr. Vega, no? And set off to complete the voyage. Only one ship and 16 men
survived.
Yes, Mr. Garcia, survived. The journey. They
arrived
back in Spain on September the 6th, 1522. They were the first men to sail around the world. Interesting. So, screenshot, and let's move. Okay, there we are. Next exercise. So the same, going back to. Going back to past continuous versus simple past. And we have this exercise where we have to put the verbs in parentheses into past simple or past continuous. So we have to evaluate and analyze if the situation or if the action is a long action in progress, or it was just the interruption of some other activity. So let's see. This is a letter, seems to be. So, dear Rick, I'm writing to you from my hotel in Switzerland. I'm having a lovely time here, but you can't imagine what happened to me yesterday. I what? Anybody?
I was in the mountain with my friend.
I was in the mountain. Okay. I was on the mountain with my friends and we
were having a lot of time.
Very good, Sofia Ore. Very good. We were having a lovely time, because that's the context. We were having a lovely time because of the snow. Sir, the verb have is a state verb. Is it possible to use with ing? If you use have just as a verb of possessing something, no. If you use have like spending time, yes. So that is the case here. No? That is why it's possible to say we were having a lovely time, because the snow. Anybody?
Was perfect.
Mr. Sakako participating. Very good. For skiing. Unfortunately, the sun.
Was shining.
Is that a question or an answer?
An answer.
So was shining. Correct. Was shining. On the snow, so it
was
difficult to see. It was difficult to see. Suddenly, I hit. I hit the rock and I
fell.
And I fell over. Luckily, I
wasn't.
Can I use which escape? Yes, he's a friend, so I can use contraction. Wasn't seriously hurt or ill. I just
got
simple pass. I just got a few bruises. Now I'm trying to be more careful. I'll see you when I get back. Best wishes, Kevin. Yes. Okay. Screenshot and share, please, with the group. Okay, next. Clear drawings. Continue. Now. Up. Mouse. And the last one, simple past versus present perfect tense. In order to do this exercise, I'm going to give you some extra time. So let's say 4 minutes, okay? 4 minutes, because I'm sure you didn't have enough time to revise all the letter. But here we have to put the verbs, as they say, into the past simple or present perfect simple. Present perfect simple. Huh? So 4 minutes or 3 minutes now, 11:50, we start doing this. Meanwhile, let me give you a task like homework. So stop sharing. Start this activity in 3 minutes. Huh? Please, can you confirm if you can access to attendance now, please? I have made some other changes. Let's see if it worked before we finish the session today. Si se me entendió, no sé. ¿Podrían acceder de nuevo a campus y ver si ya pueden registrar su asistencia? Acabo de hacer algunos cambios. Veamos si ha funcionado.
No sé, no se puede, ingeniero.
No se puede, ingeniero.
Igual.
No, no. Okay.
Se me está forzando a llamarlos dos veces. No, sí, bueno. Okay. Bueno, al final los voy a llamar de nuevo. Va a ser una pérdida de tiempo total. Now let's see. Put the verse in brackets into past simple. Sorry, sharing this. I'm sharing this quick. Tomo la foto mejor y luego los registro manualmente. Okay, dear Margaret, thank you very much for your letter, which I received last week. I was really happy. I have been really happy to hear from you after all this time. What do you think? Anybody? Volunteers, volunteers.
I was,
correct. I was very happy. Was really happy to hear from you after all this time. I have got a lot of news to tell you about myself. I was getting, but remember, it was nine months ago.
I got
because it's the result. Cuando ustedes basan una acción basada en el resultado, simple past. Si se refiere más al proceso de la actividad o de la acción, past continuous. In this case, it's a result. So, I work as a reporter for our local TV station now. I
have
many interesting experiences. I have had many interesting experiences so far. So far is an expression that we use with present perfect as well. When I first, al principio, cuando when I first started work, the manager, I referring to that first initial time, the manager
asked.
Simple past and present perfect only. Only simple past and present perfect, okay? Me to interview our old school headmaster. He so surprised to see me with a microphone. He was so surprised to see me with a microphone in my hand. Last month, a fire broke out in a big factory in the area. I was, because you described that past event, I was the only reporter who que se managed to talk to the owner. That
made
me feel very proud. As you can see, I enjoy my job very much. A lot of important people.
I met.
¿Ya no sigue conociendo gente importante? I have met. Sigo conociendo. So I have met. Very important experience. Remember, I have met a lot of important people. And I have the opportunity to see lots of places. Have had. Very good. The opportunity to see a lot of new places. I have bought a new car because my old one a couple of weeks ago Remember, I go simple past. Broke down. Yes, broke down a couple of weeks ago. I have to go now because they... Fíjense que está el just. ¿Cuándo usamos just? Present perfect o simple past? Anybody? Perfect. Eso lo hicimos
present,
hoy.
Present perfect.
Correct. So they have just...
Just simple.
Called me. Oh, sorry, informed me.
Teacher, have.
Very good. Thank you very much. And I'm going to decrease also the letter here. So I have the space. Have just informed me that I have to fly by helicopter to Middleford. I have to talk to people whose homes were damaged by the storm, which the area last night. The area last night. Last. So what do we use? Come on, guys, to finish this. Hit. Hit the area last night. You see, I don't have a moment's rest. Yes, agree? Screenshot, please. And that is. The next session, we are going to start with the new material, the material that corresponds to basic English for computing. And I have to start the class with passive voice. I'm going to upload some material, okay? So pay attention to campus before the class, please, okay? So probably Saturday, I will upload some material for you to read a little bit about passive voice and to check if I can share the book with you through that. So pay attention to this. Para las personas, vayan abriendo cámaras para ir a tomar la fotografía de la asistencia. Creo que no voy a aparecer muy bien. Para las personas que están con el trámite de la matrícula, envíenme un correo cuando ya se haya regularizado. Cuando ustedes ya vean que aparecen en ORCE, porque esa lista debe ser actualizada. Entonces, si ya están en ORCE, simplemente parcho la lista que tengo y ya los comienzo a llamar las siguientes sesiones. Por favor, no esperen hasta el lunes, porque si se dan cuenta, apenas arranco la sesión, son muchas ventanas las que tengo que abrir con ustedes. Y si me dicen, profesor, se me ha añadido, es muy poco lo que voy a poder hacer para agregarlos a la lista en ese momento. So, ready, everybody, open your cameras, please. Recuerden que si no figuran, para mí simplemente no han estado, ¿no? Su ordenador estuvo conectado, más no el usuario. Y lo digo en la grabación, así que estoy grabando para que quede data o una evidencia de lo que he dicho. Muchas gracias por los que participaron aún por el chat también. Le dieron cierto color a cierto momento de la clase. Más no pierdan la perspectiva que estamos en clase. So, ready? Pause the recording here. Not yet. Registering. Ah, okay. Es una sola. Everybody, yes. Fernando Pastor, Aste. Preparen sus cámaras, porque ojo que para las evaluaciones, el que no tiene cámara, el que está sin video, simplemente no se le considera la evaluación. Estoy avisando con mucha anticipación. Así que préstense una cámara si es que por ahí lo encuentran muy difícil para al menos estar esas 2 horas conectados. So, in 1 and 2, todos aparecen. Traten de aparecer bien en la cámara. Algunos solo se le ve la frente y el cabello. Cuando tengan su background también, que no sea un background tan cargado, porque es lo único que tengo como evidencia para ponerle presente, llegó tarde, etc. Listo. Felices, Jihuayanca. ¿No está? Well, ok. 1, 2, and 3. Todos salen bien, tranquilos, todos salen bien. Bien serios, pero salen bien. Listo. Ok, thank you very much. Pay attention to campus. En el campus voy a dejarles algo para que vayan revisando. Cualquier duda...